What if I told you behind door number one, there was a pot of gold? Would you go open a door and would you go get it? Now, I know that seems like a easy no-brainer question, but unfortunately, most people, they won't go get it. I can say, hey, there's great opportunity over there, but you got to go get it. And unfortunately, most people won't go get it. And I'm always curious about why is that the case? And as I was being curious about why is that the case, I looked at myself and I realized that's me too sometimes. Sometimes I know that the opportunity is over here, but for some reason, I can't motivate myself to go out and go get the opportunity. Think about the Israelites. When they reached the edge of the promised land, Moses said, the promised land is over here, and all you got to do is go out and go get it. But instead of going and getting it, what they say, hey, you know what? Let's send out spies and let them check out the land. And so they sent out 12 spies plus Joshua made 13. So 13 people went out into the promised land. They checked it out. And guess what? When they came back, two people, Joshua and Caleb, said, let's go get it. 11 people said, the land is too big for us. We can't take it. They're like giants. We're like grasshoppers. We can't go get it. And what God said to them, look, for every day you wasted my time, you're going to spend 1 year in the wilderness. So they was out spying the promised land for 40 days now. And so for 40 days, 1 year for every day means 40 years. They spent 40 years have to wander in the wilderness. So opportunity was literally around the corner. Gold was around the corner. Money was around the corner. You're getting out of financial pressures around the corner. But why won't you go get it? And why didn't those Israelites go get it? Why don't I get it sometimes? And the answer is simply this. We are afraid. We are afraid to take that action because in our mind, we don't see ourselves as qualified, as able, as having the right mental intellect or having the right skill sets to go out and go get that opportunity. So it's a lot easier to say, hey, there's gold around the corner and not go get it. And say, hey, there's gold around the corner and take the possibility of looking like a failure if you can't get it. So what we're doing is we're self-sabotaging ourselves because we don't want to go out and look ridiculous if this doesn't work out. We don't want to put out this big promotion and nobody shows up. We don't want to plan an event and we can't sell any tickets. So what we're going to do is we're going to protect ourselves from failure by just what? Not doing anything. So the Israelites was doing the exact same thing. They're saying there's a high chance that we can't do it. And so in order to look good and save face, let's just not do it. And that's what's happened to a lot of us. We see opportunity. There's gold around the corner. There's money around the corner. There's opportunity around the corner. But we're not going to go get it because we're scared. We're afraid. We don't want to take action. We're going to make excuses for why we can't do it or why this is not the right time or why I'm not able to do it. In Ecclesiastes, it talks about that if you look at the wind, you look at the rain, you won't sow, which means that there's never a perfect time to go after opportunity. There's never a perfect time to open that door and go get to go. There's never a perfect time to go find your opportunity. There's never a perfect time to go get your money. And the reason, as I said again, we're afraid. We're afraid to go after the opportunity. We're afraid to step out there in faith. We're afraid to truly trust God 100% that this is what he's called us to do. So sometimes that's why I was thinking about this earlier today. That's why layoffs sometimes are not necessarily a bad thing for people. When you experience a layoff at that moment in time, you are forced to get over your fear or die. Because if you don't do something, you're going to run out of money and you're not going to be able to pay for your family, your food, your house, whatever. At that point, the need to survive sometimes overcomes the fear of not acting. But when you got a job, when things are not really comfortable, but you're kind of surviving. Because think about the Israelites. They were in slavery for 400 years. You know, things weren't great, but they were eating. You know, they had a roof over their head. You know, so they was, you know, it wasn't great, but it was comfortable. But the thought of going out there, going after their own opportunity was just a little too much. So Moses had to come and literally rip them out of Egypt. Because, I mean, there in any civilization, when you have slavery, there's always more slaves and slave masters. So the slaves at any moment can always rise up. Even with our culture in Black America, when we were slaves here in the United States, and it was way more of us than it were of them. We could have easily rose up and got out of there. But what happens with slavery is that slavery is more of a mindset thing. It's a thing where you want to trap a person in here so they don't take action and move out on what they're supposed to do. So this is a story I've learned. I was listening to this guy named Pat Flynn. He got his new book out called Let Go. And what he said is a story of elephants. And when an elephant is young, they put a chain around his foot. And the chain is so strong that he can't break free. And what they're doing is they're training him to saying, you can't break out of this situation. And so as the elephant gets bigger and full grown, they put that same chain around his ankles. And at this point, he's been trained that he can't get out of it. So he doesn't even attempt to break free. But at this point, he's so big, he could easily snap that chain and get free. But he won't, because he's been trained to know, I tried it before, it didn't work, so I'm not going to do it anymore. He's scared. He's afraid of failure. And what we got to do is we got to get over this fear of failure. We got to get over this fear of looking bad. We got to get over the mental roadblocks that's only in here that's stopping us from success, that's stopping from opening that door of goal, that's stopping from us getting money, that's stopping us from our opportunity, because we're trapped in here. It's like we're in a prison and the door is only locked in our mind. Now, I don't know how true this story was, but I heard the story in the past. I don't know if this is a folklore or fiction, but it's a story of Houdini. He's a great escape artist. So they put him in a jail cell and he told him to try to get out of this jail cell. Now, he tried everything to get out of jail cell, but he couldn't. Only thing he didn't try was just opening the door. And guess what? The door was unlocked. So in our mind, if the door is locked, we're not even going to try to open it, even if it's around the corner. You know, James Brown said, just show me the door to open myself, right, one time. So we got to say, look, there's gold around that corner. And the goal is in your ideals, is in what God's called to do. And all you got to do is open the door. And it's not locked, guys. It's not locked at all. It's just that it seems locked because it's closed. But you got to take the step of faith to open it and go out there and do what God's called you to do and step out and get that goal, get that money he's promised you. Now, you say, Amos, you're talking a lot about money this year. Yeah, I'm talking a lot about money this year, because as Christians, we got to get more comfortable with going after money. Not just believing for money to come through a financial miracle. We have to get comfortable with this concept of money makes this world go round. Money provides for things. Ecclesiastes says money is the answer for all things. Money answers all things. Now, we know that money is not salvation. We know that money is not going to get us to heaven. We know that money is not holy or unholy in and of itself. We know that it's just a tool. But you have to be comfortable with using the tool, or else the tool will crush you. So I need you to get comfortable with the concept of going after making a whole bunch of money, making so much money that it's scary. It's scary how much money you can make. A lot of times people just so sabotage themselves because they don't want to seem cool. They don't want to see detached. They don't want to go after that $1 million idea. They don't want to go after that invention because nobody else is doing it. They haven't seen it modeled before. It's like they want to stay in this nice little comfort area. Well, if I can just make six figures, I'd be cool. Or if I could just do this, if I can get this promotion, I can just do this, you know, we'd be cool. But no. God is not about just being cool. God's not just about being comfortable. God is about you stepping out there, taking the bull by the horns and going out there and making as much money as you possibly can before you leave this planet. And you might say to yourself, why do I need to make so much? Well, you got to make so much because God says better be a blessing. It's better to be a blessing than it is to receive, which means that there's a lot of works out here that's bigger than you and your whole family. So in some sense, it's a selfish thing if you don't live up to your full potential and go after the goal, go after the money that God has placed in your heart to go get. Because there's things and works that he needs to do, and he needs you to go pull up other people that's behind you that need to have the same mindset. And the only way to do it, you got to reach them with the goal and the money that you currently have. But if you don't have it, if you don't step out, everybody's still in a bad situation. So we got to go out there, get over our fears and say, hey, there's gold around that corner. There's opportunity and I need to go get it. All right, so that's what I want to talk about with you guys on this Friday. And what I want to do is, as we close now, I'm going to mention that I am working on an online course that's based on my book, Take Control of Your Financial Destiny. Now, this course is going to be a self-paced audio course with text, with questions, and it's going to teach you how to take what's in here, convert it into a business, and go make profit from that particular thing. It's coming out soon. And if for everybody on my email list, you're going to get it for half price when it comes out. So if you're not on my list, you need to get on my list. If you are on my list, look out for it's coming in the future. And if you can't wait for the course, I always have advisement sessions ready to go to strategize, but what God's told you to do very personally to help you get going. So it's really no need to wait. There's gold around the corner. Just got to go open the door. All right, it's Amos Johnson. Talk to you guys later. Be blessed.